Hi guys, my name is Vivek and in this video we are going to discuss about chunk dimensions. As I've done in my previous video tutorials, I'm going to explain this with a real project scenario and we are going to understand what are chunk dimensions, what is the significance of chunk dimensions and in what scenarios we should implement them. So we are going to understand this with the example of a fact table that has billion rows. So here we are talking about a clothing line that's selling its product online and in store. Here is the snapshot of the transaction table or the metadata, how it looks like. So if we form the transaction table with all these columns, the first one is the surrogate key, the transaction ID. Then we have the product ID, which symbolizes the product that is being sold. Then the customer who bought the product, his ID. The employee who assisted in the transaction, his ID. Then we have this degenerate dimension. Degenerate dimension is something that does not have any descriptive dimension. It's just a single column. And maybe I'll make a separate video for this. I've already explained this in one of my previous videos though. Then we have these three columns that are in question: payment ID, location ID, and coupon ID. Payment ID is how the payment was made, whether it was made with card, cash, location is in store, online, and whether a coupon was used. And then we have two measures, which are amount and quantity. Now the three columns that we have in question here are payment ID, location ID, and coupon ID. And all these three columns have low cardinality. So this is one of the characteristics of the chunk dimension, that they will always have low cardinality. Now let's see what are the possible values for these three columns. So the mode of payment, it can be card or cash. The location of purchase, it can be in store or online. And then we have the coupon used, it can be Y or N. Now if we look at the real transaction table with the previous metadata that I just showed, it has these three columns being repeated a billion times. For example, the first row signifies that the payment was made using card in store and the coupon was used, and the same goes for the other rows here as well that I showed. But because of this, we are doing two things. We are adding three additional small tables in question, and say if I want to retrieve the details of the transaction that were done in store and a coupon was used and the mode of payment was cash, in order to retrieve this data, I'll have to join these three tables with the transaction table, which is making my warehouse design a little complex. At the same time, my storage is being increased because I'm storing these a billion times. So these three, is there a different way I can treat these three columns? Let's see the different way, the other possible way. So the other possible way is, instead of having those three tables, I can directly go ahead and store the data in my transaction table. So the payment mode can be card or cash. The location can be online and store, and the coupon code. So the first one, the first order ID, it signifies that it was paid by a card, it was purchased online, and a coupon was used. The second order ID, it specified that it was bought by a card in store and no coupon was used, and that kind of stuff. The challenge is that for a billion rows, we are adding lot of redundant information. These are low cardinality columns, and we keep on repeating them in all these billion rows. The challenge with the previous approach was we were adding additional complexity in our design, because now we have to retrieve the details. We had to join with three small tables to our fact table, that was increasing the join complexity. Here we are actually like this, my storage cost, it's increasing because I'm storing a lot of redundant data. So what's the best way to do this? So the best way to do this as I mentioned that these are the Jung dimensions, they are low cardinality dimensions, and the approach that we are going to tell you now, it's going to reduce your fact size and it's going to reduce your model complexity. So what I can do is I can create a single table from these three tables by taking a Cartesian product of these columns and assigning a single row to them. For example, this card in store and coupon will be an individual row with ID 1, the card in store and no coupon will be ID 2, and so on. We will see how it looks like. So when we did the Cartesian product, we got 8 rows. The first row says card in store and Y. The second row says card in store and N. The third is card online Y, and so on. So these dimensions, they actually are not meaningful. If you see like card in store and Y, they are not exactly descriptive, or they actually do not like are not very cohesive. But still, if I use this in my fact table, I'm just going to use the ID, so it reduces my complexity of the model, and at the same time it reduces my storage cost as well, because here I'm only storing 8 rows, and in my transaction table I'll just have one ID column. So let's see how my transaction table will look now. So my billion row transaction table, which is actually my warehouse table, it will just have one column instead of three columns, and that will be the ID. So the one will signify that it was done with a card online and a coupon was used. The two will signify for the second order ID that it was bought by a card online and no coupon was used. The third will signify that it was paid by a card in store and the coupon was used. The five, it will signify that it was bought by cash in store and the coupon was used. So this transaction table, it looks more feasible. We have reduced the join complexity by joining only with one table. The storage space has also decreased, because instead of storing three string rows, we are just having one single dimension, and that too, I mean, it's like pretty small, right? So it's not going to capture much space. Now, what's the challenge, or what are the things that you need to take into consideration when you are making a Jung dimension? The first thing that we should consider is that the cardinality of the Jung dimension should be low, otherwise our Jung dimension will explode. For example, imagine three dimensions that can have 100 values each. So 100 multiplied by 100 multiplied by 100 is 1 million rows. That means you will have a huge Jung dimensions, and you don't want that. What is the advantage of Jung dimension, or why do we want to use them? We should not add unnecessary columns to the fact table. It increases my model complexity and it costs me storage space. We should not create too many small dimensions. They are difficult to maintain. And the second thing is, I'll have to join my fact table with too many tables, which will increase my complexity. So these are the two things that are actually solved by Jung dimensions, but we need to make sure that our Jung dimensions should not have too many values, or like the cardinality should be low. And we usually load our Jung dimensions on a practical feasibility basis. For example, if we go back here and we see that you cannot purchase something online with cash, so we will not even load this row. So instead of having 8 rows, we will have only 6 rows, that kind of stuff. So it's usually you load as you need, or you load only the practical and feasible values in the real world scenarios. So the two things that the Jung dimensions solve is, it reduces the fact size and it reduces the model complexity. The thing you need to consider while creating a Jung dimension is that all the dimensions that you will be joining together, they should have low cardinalities and less number of rows. So hopefully guys, this video clears what are Jung dimensions. why you should not have too many columns in your fact table, why you should what is the purpose of chunk dimension, and that kind of stuff. In case if you still have any question, please let me know in the comment section, and I'll explain chunk dimension possibly through a different real world example, but hopefully it should be clear by now. If you like this video, please do give it a thumbs up. It actually I feel a sense of appreciation, and it helps me to devote more time towards making these videos and sharing my knowledge. And do subscribe to my channel for all the latest videos that I have been uploading lately. Thanks a lot guys for watching this video and sparing your time.